The Raiders' search for a replacement number 7 will continue after Titans authorities informed them that co-captain Jamal Fogarty will not be allowed an early release to relocate to Canberra. Ricky Stewart's interest in bringing Fogarty south was revealed on Wednesday, despite the fact that the late-blooming 27-year-old signed a Titans extension just last month that would keep him at the club until the end of 2023. Raiders officials revealed to NRL.com that Titans counterparts had ruled out an early release, as Brisbane confirmed the acquisition of Ryan James from Canberra on a one-year agreement for 2022. According to sources, conversations between the Gold Coast and Fogarty's team were very touchy. It's uncertain whether Fogarty's management will advocate for his release in the future if it means securing his future elsewhere. Who do you think is the best rookie of the year? Who do you think is the best rookie of the year? Who do you think is the best rookie of the year? Gold Coast CEO Steve Mitchell declined to comment or clarify the club's position on Fogarty's future, stating that as a club policy, we do not comment on recruitment or retention. According to NRL rules, Fogarty would need the Titans' consent to begin official negotiations with competitors because his most recent agreement knocked him off the free agent list in 2023. Fogarty is well-liked at the Titans, as evidenced by his leadership alongside Kevin Proctor after only 41 NRL appearances, but he will face competition for a starting halves spot next season. The emergence of Toby Sexton and Jaden Campbell, together with AJ Brimson, has given coach Justin Holbrook a selection issue, though Fogarty is said to have strong support to keep the number 7 jersey as Sexton develops. The Raiders are still interested in released Titans utility Tyrone Peachy, and the West's Tigers are also thought to be interested in him. Canberra is concerned about Peachy's asking price because a halves partner for Jack Whiten is their top priority on the roster. Prior to the developments surrounding Fogarty, veteran Raiders recruitment chief Peter Mulholland stated that James's release to the Broncos would result in additional monies being added to Canberra's halfback quest. While fellow Raiders veteran Junamis Louis has also been advised he would not be resigned, James has now officially signed a one-year deal with the Broncos after being in their sights on multiple occasions over his career. "We've made no secret that we've been seeking for an experienced forwards to reinforce our pack and assist our younger forwards grow and progress. Ryan James fits that bill perfectly," Broncos football director Ben Eichen said. "Not only is he still playing outstanding football, but he is also a great leader who exemplifies the behaviors we are attempting to instill in our playing group." Canberra has been looking for a game-managing halfback since George Williams abruptly returned to the United Kingdom with 18 months remaining on his contract. Williams was making roughly $600,000 per season in Canberra, but given the club's lack of quality halves in the market, it is not necessarily a price it is looking to spend on his replacement. "We're still looking for a halfback," Mulholland told NRL.com. "We've set aside a good sum for that, I wouldn't say it's a significant amount. We're not likely to replace Ryan James with a similar player because we have a bunch of talented young middles who can aid us in that case. It's not that we didn't want Ryan James to stay. It's more that he wasn't going to be offered a contract beyond next year, and we believed it would be in his best benefit, if the opportunity arose, for him to return to Queensland with his family." Former Titans playmaker Ash Taylor has previously been courted by the Raiders, but he is also on the Warriors' radar after meeting with club officials last week. No offer has yet been made to the 26-year-old, but both parties see benefits in partnering with the Kiwi franchise, who will be headquartered in Redcliffe next season. V.